that time, while Jesus was speaking, behold, the ruler came in and knelt before him, saying, "My daughter has just died, but come and lay your hand on her, and she will live." And Jesus rose and followed him with his disciples. And behold, the woman who had suffered from a hemorrhage for 12 years came up behind him and touched the fringe of his garment, for she had said to herself, "If only I touch his garment, I shall be made well." Jesus turned and seeing her, he said, "Take heart, daughter, your faith has made you well." And instantly, the woman was made well. When Jesus came to the ruler's house and saw the flute player and the crowd making a tumult, he said, "Depart, for the girl is not dead, but sleeping." And they laughed at him. But when the crowd had been put outside, he went in and took her by the hand, and the girl arose, and the report of this went through all that district. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, the Gospel of this morning reminds us of two kinds of cases. People who have prolonged sickness and suffering, and also people who have cases that are considered to be hopeless. In the case of the little girl, it was a seemingly hopeless case because even the father told us that she was dead. He believed that if Jesus Christ touched her dead daughter, that she will come back to life. We all are familiar with many hopeless cases, many difficult cases, many cases that are beyond the capacity of man to heal. Those cases, let us not lose faith. Let us learn to bring them before our Lord Jesus. Jesus Christ does not stop there. Also, he deals with cases that are prolonged. This woman was hemorrhaging for about 12 years, and he took everything away from her. It's our prayer that we'll never have issues in our lives that will take everything away from us. But that was the case of this woman. She would have sold all her property, she would have sold all her lands, she would have sold all her houses if she had any. But definitely, this was a case that drained everything from her. Perhaps even drained her spiritually, drained her even socially, because she could not relate anymore with those around her. So let us pray through the grace of this Mass that we remember people who are in both categories. People who are experiencing hopeless cases, and people who have been suffering for so long that their faith is terribly shaken. We pray that our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought healing to both categories of people, will remember those in our midst who are experiencing those kinds of sufferings, and it will bring restoration and wholeness to them through Christ.